Daya and I are back, and we're ready and happy to announce that our local niche perfume shop now carries Pierre Guillaume fragrances. Pierre Guillaume is a fragrance brand that I fell in love with back in 2013 when I first discovered it in France, in the south of France. One of my favorite fragrances from the house is called Cozy. But today in this video, we are reviewing, what is this called?
Komorebi.
Komorebi 9.1 from Pierre Guillaume, which was launched in 2018, last year. We're doing this review, plus we have a full bottle to give away. If you're curious to find out about this fragrance and have a chance at winning a full bottle, please stay tuned. Thanks so much for tuning in. This is Sebastian, this is Dahlia. If this is your first time tuning into this channel and you love watching fragrance reviews, finding out about new fragrances, discovering new brands, and of course participating in giveaways, and you still haven't subscribed to this channel, please click the subscribe button below and also click the bell so you'll be notified for future videos and giveaways. So how many of you know about the house Pierre Guillaume? It used to be called, well, this particular house used to be called Parfumerie Generale, but Pierre Guillaume as a brand has four different collections and they were all different names, and I believe they got renamed a couple of years ago to just be called Pierre Guillaume. As you can see, the name is on the back of the label, and this is Komorebi 9.1, launched in 2018. These are sold at ZGO Perfumery here in San Francisco. A 50 ml bottle like this retails for $125. The perfumer is Pierre Guillaume, and this is EDP concentration. So what do we like about this one?
Before we do that, we have background insight really from Claude at ZGO about this brand in particular and how they develop their...
Yes, tell us.
This is going to be me remembering, so apologies if you're watching, Claude. But apparently they're unique in that they source their own ingredients or distill their own ingredients. I don't know how much of it is local or what the background is. If I was a responsible contributor to this channel, I would have Googled it before I mentioned it, but either way,
What are you trying to say?
I didn't do any research. I am passing along what I have heard. But that there's a real care and craftsmanship that goes into the construction, I guess, of these fragrances.
There's actually, if you're also ever in Paris, make sure to stop into their boutique, which is a nice little boutique. But before we move on with the review, I also forgot to mention the notes in this fragrance. When we first smelled this fragrance, something really jumped out at me, the notes. But for top notes, you have mint, which is very unusual. In the heart notes, you have resita, mimosa, and blackcurrant. Another note I had never even heard before, resita. Have you heard of it?
Nope.
Resita, there's a city in California called Resita in the Southern California. But this is a flower. It's some kind of a weedy flower. And then in the base notes, you have hazel, oak, tonka beans. So pretty much that's all that's going on. But for me, when I first smelled this, something jumped out at me. It's the mimosa. And lately I've been obsessed with mimosa. Even though I hated a mimosa like a year and a half, 2 years ago, I couldn't stand the note. Now I'm obsessed with it.
Now you can't get enough?
But this is a mimosa dominant fragrance, but it's very green on the
very green and vegetal. That's what caught me. Is, you know, we just stopped by and we're looking at the whole display, and I, you know, had 47 different, I don't know how many there are, but, you know, perfume all over. And this is the one that really jumped out because it's this beautiful sort of vegetal green, which you would think from the ingredients comes from the mint, but there's got to be more to it. I think it's probably the mix of the mint and whatever the resita is. I don't know what it is, or what, I wouldn't know it if you put it in front of my face. But it's a green that has some staying power, even though it's quite fresh.
And what do you think about the mimosa? Because mimosa is a, like I said, it used to be a tough flower for me. It goes into like a honey immortelle-like direction, kind of fuzzy. They're little yellow flowers that grow on trees. They're beautiful, but...
Considering that I don't like immortelle and I don't like honey, it's very strange that I do like mimosa.
But do you generally like mimosa, or is it just in this fragrance?
I have. I like this fragrance. I like the... There's one by Wilhelm, whatever that brand is, that's a mimosa.
Wilhelm Parfumerie.
Yeah. I like that mimosa, so I probably like mimosas. I like drinking mimosas.
Well.
Not the same. I really like everything I've smelled from this line so far. There's a real variety.
Do you like Cozy?
Oh, well, that's actually what got my attention, is his bottle of Cozy. It's a sort of tobacco-like...
Patchouli.
Well, there you go.
Cannabis.
Hashtag.
Chocolate.
I wouldn't ordinarily say that I like gourmand, so I...
It's not really a gourmand.
No, but it's a tobacco patchouli, really. Not on the floral side of tobacco, on the tobacco side of tobacco.
Tobacco side, yeah. The dirty side of tobacco.
Yeah. This one is a nice... So part of the reason when we were looking at what we wanted to talk about, I mean, it's not just that it's a new release. It's also really good for this time of year.
I think it's a great spring fragrance. It's green, which is, you know, springy. And then mimosa is also, like, very springy.
But it's fresh without being a freshie. It's light without being a skin scent. It's got projection. It's just not a heavy fragrance. And it's...
I think it's the nice balance of everything you said. It's not a wimp. It's not a beast fragrance. It's perfect. I think it's a perfect spring scent if you're looking for something different than a typical citrus or a floral. Because even though this is a floral fragrance, you're experiencing the mimosa, which is not your typical flower. You're experiencing resedia.
It's aromatic. Yeah.
It's very aromatic, and it's very green.
And it's not floral. Like he said, you know, floral, I think as soon as people hear that, they go, oh, well, I
don't like flowers.
I don't like flowers. But, I mean, you'd wear geranium, wouldn't you? I mean, you'd
wear... Yeah, it's a flower. Lavender.
Technically, flowers. I mean, it's that kind of, like, more...
Flowers wild. That are not flowers.
Well, but, like, that grow wild, you know, that are, like, part of a field, not, like, in a garden. Right? You know what I mean? Where it's more like you're walking through, like, on a hike, and you smell something bright and green and natural, and it happens to be a flower, but it's not floral.
Yeah, it's not a tuberose, it's not a jasmine, it's not a gardenia, it's not even rose.
No, it's none of those things. They are other flowers.
So would you consider this a unisex or more leaning masculine or more leaning feminine?
I would absolutely consider it unisex.
Right down the middle.
Yeah, I think anybody can wear it.
What about the mint at the top? It's pretty short-lived for me.
I think it's got to be staying there throughout because it's so green. And of the ingredients, what else is as green as mint? But it's not a mint. It's not like a chewing gum mint, and it's not.
It's not a chewing. No.
You know what I mean, though, right? Yeah. But it's mint, like the plant, like that spreads everywhere and takes over your yard, like mint, and it's
authentic mint.
Mint, like the plant, and it's
like a Moroccan mint tea mint,
or like Abd el Kadar, like the Sir Chudan candle that we both are obsessed with.
Oh yeah, that's
A good mint.
That's a good mint.
That's a really good mint. So this is like that kind of mint, you know, the plant. I'm going to stop saying that now.
So what do you think about the dry down? It dries down to hazelnuts, oak, the tree, and then tonka beans.
I, on my skin, didn't get hazelnuts at all.
Did you get any oak and tonka beans?
I might have gotten oak, but for me, it just sort of stayed green.
To me, it stays... I think mostly it's all about a green mimosa for me.
It's pretty linear.
Dries down to a little bit of woody touches in the base, but it's still mostly about the mimosa and the green. And I don't know where that green is coming from. Is it the mint or the resedia?
The mystery green. It's... Anyway, if you haven't checked out this brand, get a sample set or something.
Komarebi 9.1. A few other fragrances that I like from this house, of course, Kose, Musk Maori, the Musk Lipo.
That's on my list.
And then there's Indochine, there's Arabian Horse.
What was that one that smelled very lemony? Something fun to see, like
Grand Seacle, something like that. And then there's also the tea one that I always forget the name of. The best tea scent I've ever put my nose on, next to Tea for Two.
And then they have a new sort of sideline that's part of this, where some of the bottles are white and some of the bottles are black, and the white ones are, what are they supposed to be, like, fresh, and the dark ones are...
The clean fragrances. Yeah.
Clean and dirty.
They just launched the three clean fragrances, and those were really nice,
too. Those are beautiful. Yeah. But the dirty ones were, like, those...
The black bottles. We call them dirty, but they're not really...
They're not dirty. They're not, like, funky. They're maybe a little heavier... Bigger than...
Yeah, more beast than pure white.
Which is what you would expect, I would think. But I'm delighted. Next time I am not wearing perfume, I'm going to go in there so I can smell through because I'm excited about this one. I don't know which one is going to be mine, but I'm excited to pick one.
Yeah, this one's really nice. I'm glad we did this review and to start with something that's very, very unique. And this is now maybe going to become the mimosa year of the mimosa.
Well, I didn't we already say it was the leather year?
Oh, no. Is it?
We did say it was.
Okay.
We could change our minds,
okay.
Though.
Well, leather and mimosa.
Yes.
Together?
I want to go to that party. I'm joking.
Well, maybe during Folsom Street Fair, we'll have a leather party with mimosas on the menu.
Maybe. We'll see.
Anyway, guys, are you familiar with the house of Pierre Guillaume? Do you know Parfumerie Générale? It's not called Parfumerie Générale anymore. It's Pierre Guillaume. Also, do you know about ZGO Perfumery? If you are in San Francisco, of course, you can visit them in the Castro. They have a website as well. And we are doing a full bottle giveaway of this one. It's valued at $125 for a subscriber of this channel. All you have to do is let us know what your favorite mimosa favorite mimosa fragrance is. And if you don't have a favorite mimosa fragrance, let us know what your favorite green fragrance is. And also let us know what you liked about this review. And put your state, because this is open to USA residents. If you have any questions or comments, please list below. Otherwise, please like this video. Please share it. Follow me on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram. And I'll be back with more videos very soon. Have a good one. Goodbye.